My next guest's band turns 30 in a couple of weeks. And they were brilliant at Radio 2 in the Park, and they're back with a brand new album. It's called The Forest is the Path. Good morning, Gary Lightbody.
Good morning, Scott Mills. How are you?
I'm very good. I don't think I've seen you for 15 years.
It could be that long, yeah.
It could be that long, yeah. Preston, loads of fun, wasn't it?
Yeah, Preston was brilliant. Really great.
You did the right thing by performing on Saturday because you missed, I think, all of the mud.
Yeah, I heard that the Sunday was a little rainy, shall we say?
It was Glastonbury level, I would say.
Oh, dear.
But I'm asking everyone, as we did have some issues, when you got home, did you find any worms in the suitcase or any clothing? Because I don't know what's happening in Preston, but there's some kind of thing going on with worms.
I did not find any worms, no. Right. Yeah, I think that might have been the deluge's fault on the Sunday.
Yeah. Just check again, though, any bag that you took.
I will check my carry-on luggage.
Yeah. You and the band played, I mean, the perfect mix of new and old tracks. But again, it must be hard to find that mix in a festival environment because they all want the hits.
Yeah, and I understand that as well. We all, you know, me, Johnny, and Nathan understand that. We want to make that, we want to find that balance. You don't want to play something, too many new songs in a row or something like that. So you want to mix it up a little bit, play a few new ones, but mostly old.
I think someone else that found exactly the right balance was Sting, because we had him in for an interview at the weekend in Preston, and he says he absolutely loves playing his hits. Like, he's so proud of those songs.
Yeah, I feel exactly the same way. And they also, they're different every night because the crowd is different every night, and they sing along in different places, and sometimes crowds sing the guitar lines, and some, you know, like, it's you know, it always makes it completely unique.
Before we talk about the new album, can we quickly talk Oasis? Because you supported the boys back in the day.
Yes, we were on before them at V 2009, and we played festivals alongside them as well.
Have you got any plans next summer?
we're making our own plans. If you're asking us, have Oasis asked us to play with them? No, they haven't.
Here's the thing, it's a difficult one, isn't it? Because you don't really want to ask yourself, because then you look way too keen.
Yeah, no, those are their gigs. We've got our gigs going on. We love Oasis. I'm so glad they're back.
Right, let's talk about the new album, The Forest is the Path. You wrote it in the middle of Somerset, and you started with an absolute blank canvas, like nothing.
Yeah, nothing. Johnny and I got together in Somerset in the little house and just had a guitar, a piano, and a blank piece of paper, and wrote the beginning on the first day, which became the first single. And it was just a great start to the process.
So is it normally music first, lyrics afterwards?
Normally, and I did write a lot of lyrics before this album, even before we even got in to write it. I was writing a lot in my notes on my phone or in little books that I have that I was carrying around, and it was just, it was kind of, I had an awful lot of prep, which you would think after 30 years I would have prepared for an album before now, but no, this was the first time I ever prepared for anything. So it was great to be able to have lines that I could take out from those notes and put onto that blank page, so you're not staring at the blank page, which is one of the, you know, sort of more traumatic things for writers.
Gary, I would love to see the notes in your phone.
Yeah, well, you can have a look.
Can I have
my phone's
a look?
Back now somewhere.
Yeah, I would like to.
Okay.
Like, I don't need the list of the big shop. Just tell me, you know, related to the Snow Patrol music.
There's an awful lot of get bread, yeah. Milk. Yeah. Basically, I was writing down things down like time, the stacking of time, past, present, future, the block universe theory. So that was a big thing for me. Everything, like Carlo Rovelli's book, The Order of Time, was a big inspiration for this record, that time is actually past, present, and future is happening in every moment. And that kind of meant a lot to me, because when I lost my dad, I don't want to get too sad in the morning, but when I lost my dad, I saw him everywhere. And I thought, and when I read that book, I was like, yeah, time is happening, like past and present and future is happening all the time. I just felt the real sense of it. So I kind of wanted to explore that in the record.
Anything else in there?
Yeah, there's loads of stuff. Okay, I mean, there's lots of sort of poetic things.
Mm-hmm. I would expect nothing
silence
less.
Silence is a new thunder we can't escape from. We can no longer distinguish between chaos
this
and love.
This is a real insight for me.
Stop trying to be something and just be. Maybe that's just a note to myself.
Right, don't move. We've got lots more to talk about. First, though, let's play The Beginning by Snow Patrol. I understand you recorded this in one take.
The vocals, yeah, but many, many other songs. All the other songs were many, many takes. This one, not so much.
So when you're hearing this, this is a one-take wonder from Gary Lightbody from Snow Patrol. This is Radio 2.
Love, if you're near, don't tell it like it is, 'cause I don't know how to hear or to learn. 'Cause I wanna be in love without being loved in return. But hold me close, 'cause I wanna feel your fire like signals on the coast. And let it rage like the end of everything in this epoch, in this age. There is only you. Being scared of what you give me, I am sorry unequivocally. I just don't know how to love.
Tuesday morning, BBC Radio 2, it's Scott Mills here in for Zoe, and this morning our guest is Gary Lightbody, and that was The Beginning. Good morning.
Good morning, Scott.
So when Dame Jo Wiley played that song with you back in May, she played it three times.
Yes.
Safe to say, we quite enjoy that song at Radio 2.
Yes, I really appreciate it. I'd never experienced that before, and I'm not sure anybody's experienced that before, but it was amazing.
I think it has happened on rare occasions with big, big songs, which that is one of, obviously. And it must be so special hearing how much people love the new album. Does that ever get old, especially because this is quite a personal record?
No, doesn't get old, if people like it.
Yeah.
No, it's, you know, as you said at the start, we've been together 30 years, and it's, you just don't take anything for granted. And when you bring a new record out, I read an interview once that Bono said, yeah, treat every record like it's your first. I took that to heart.
Yeah.
Because you don't ever want to think that you don't ever want to expect something.
Do you know who loves you? loves Snow Patrol, loves the new music, James Corden. He was on with Zoe Ball when it had just come out. Have a listen to this.
It makes me very emotional listening to that song. I think it's just brilliant. And he is, gorgeous. It's so good. It's the best song of the year. It's amazing.
Now, didn't you perform at his wedding?
I did, yes.
Right. Okay. Yeah, and Royal Albert Hall.
Yeah, James sang, set the fire to the third bar with us at Royal Albert Hall. Yeah. And yeah, he did a beautiful, beautiful job. He's got an amazing voice. Yeah, I performed his wedding, and the funny thing was there were so many comedians in the room, so you could expect what happens after that.
Yeah.
So everybody kind of like, should you have sung that in the right key?
Oh, God. You know what I mean? That's fun. Yeah, I mean, he's been a long-time fan.
Yeah.
And when he was in, Zoe had this question from Jane and Heather Jean.
I really hope that new Snow Patrol song features in the next and final episode of Gavin and Stacey. It is perfect for all the characters. Will you put a word in, please?
Do you want to know the absolute truth?
Yeah.
It really did cross my mind when I listened to it, because they've been a real constant in our show, really.
Yeah.
Series one, we used their song, You Could Be Happy. It was really one of the only times we'd ever said, we're going to use this song in this bit. And then I think we used in series two, we used Open Your Eyes. And it would be nice to find a space.
he hasn't asked me, but if they want one, they can have one, that's for sure.
It's true. I do associate your songs a lot with that show.
I mean, it's an honour to be part of that show in a small way. It's an honour.
James, if you're listening, call Gary. They haven't even finished filming it yet. It's on in 99 days from now. It's on Christmas Day.
Yeah.
Surely, like, they've got to use Snow Patrol one more time.
I hope so.
Also, great news for fans of the band. You're off on tour next year.
Yes.
As you were saying earlier. As I said before, Snow Patrol turns 30 on the 30th. That must feel mad.
Yes. Yeah, yeah. I, you know, started the band in Dundee University the second day, that I was there. So I arrived on the 29th of September and met the original bass player, Mark McClelland, on the 30th. And we started the band together then. That was 30 years ago in a couple of weeks.
Have you got a party planned or anything?
I hadn't thought about that. We really probably should.
Maybe you should. Yeah. What was university Gary like? Was he tidy? Was he thoughtful?
He was definitely not tidy.
No.
Yeah, he was definitely not tidy.
Writing songs.
Friends of mine at the time will laugh at the thought of me being tidy. Yeah, no, I was definitely the least tidy of anybody that I knew.
Before you go, Gary, is it true that you're also writing a novel?
Yes, but I don't know that I've... Did I mention that somewhere? Okay, I must have done. Sorry. But yes, it will be out next year, in the start of the year. Yeah.
Exciting times. Mm. I can't wait for all of it. Snow Patrol's new album, The Forest is the Path, is out now. Plus, tickets are available to see them on tour next February. And whenever you want, you can enjoy their Radio 2 in the Park set on iPlayer, which is brilliant. Or listen on sound. For both of those, to listen or watch, just search In the Park. Gary Lightbody, thank you so much for joining me this morning.
Cheers, Scott. Thank you so much. Radio 2.